Welcome back to another episode of the show. I'm your host, David Womack, and let's dive right into TV and movie news. In our first bit of news, the director for Scream 7 calls it quits. Christopher Landon exits the movie following departures of Melissa Barrera and Jenna Ortega. Chris goes on to say, "It was a dream job that turned into a nightmare," Landon wrote on X, as he announced he will no longer direct the upcoming seventh Scream film. So it looks like the next Scream film is without a director. So to all you directors out there, now's your chance. Christopher Landon was the filmmaker who took over directing duties for Scream 7 back in August. Landon's departure from the forthcoming film follows news that Melissa Barrera nor Jenna Ortega, who co-starred in the franchise's most two recent films, Chris mentioned, "I guess now is a good time as any to announce I formally exited Scream 7 weeks ago. This will disappoint some and delight others. It was a dream job that turned into a nightmare, and my heart did break for everyone involved. Everyone. But it's time to move on." So Chris went on to say more. I think you guys should look it up. But pretty much Chris, his resume is movies like Paranormal Activity, The Marked Ones, Freaky and the Happy Death Day. Since after Wes Craven died, that series has been in the need of a serious boost. So I hope they all can come together and make something happen. And maybe Christopher can get back on board. You know, who knows? Our next bit of news. Netflix decided to surprise release the Rebel Moon trailer for part 2, The Scargiver. Netflix has announced that it will release the follow-up to Rebel Moon part 1, A Child of Fire, on April 19th. Arriving 4 months after the premiere of Part 1, The Scargiver will continue Snyder's epic saga, with Korra and the surviving warriors preparing to sacrifice everything as they fight alongside the people of Velt. On the eve of their battle as the heroes defend a once peaceful village, a newfound homeland for those who have lost their own in the fight against the Mother World. These warriors are forced to face their past and in turn each reveal why they stand and fight. The film promises that amid the full force of the realm bearing down on a burgeoning rebellion, bonds will be forged that are unbreakable and both heroes and legends will be made. While Rebel Moon Part 2 doesn't release until April 19th, it's pretty obvious that we're going to get a lot more from this Star Wars inspired drama. And I think that Snyder is thinking franchise. In our next bit of news, Aquaman pretty much flopped over the weekend, and DC is having a field day with this. They're pretty much trolling themselves. Aquaman is back, and he's got a new poster that's making waves in all the wrong directions. It's been a whopping 5 years since Jason Momoa last graced the screen with a new release over the holiday weekend, Aquaman 2. Warner Brothers Discovery seems to have let their intern run wild with the design, and the result is a poster that's about as confusing as trying to understand the DC timeline. Momoa's Aquaman is now a king and a father, and the poster desperately tries to convey that. But it's more like a fish out of water than a ruler of Atlantis. In a recent interview, Jason Momoa did declare that this is the grand finale for the DCEU films. He also mentioned it's been 12 years and the DCEU is at its end. He was probably realizing that even superheroes need a break. Jason Momoa worked really hard on this project and, you know, they've been through so much. It's been 12 long years. You know, what they produced was really good. It was a really good production. It's just that it fell flat and a lot of the plot holes just weren't answered. So hopefully in the future, you know, Jason Momoa himself, if he does dive back into the superhero realm, he would, you know, learn from his mistakes and just give us the best work that he possibly can. Now, I don't see anything Oscar-worthy in the future for him, but, you know, anything could happen. In our next bit of news, Nicolas Cage pretty much discusses his new movie, Dream Scenario, and he thinks that this is his best production yet, like ever. Nicolas Cage says that the movie Dream Scenario is one of his best and personal performances, as he was nominated for his 5th Golden Globe. Nicolas Cage has been an actor around for nearly 30, maybe 40 years, and he's well known in the acting world and in the world period. With him calling this particular movie his best ever, that says a lot. And, you know, I don't want to put extra weight or extra gravity on him, but that's some huge shoes to fill. I mean, you have Gone in 60 Seconds, where Nicolas Cage played a thief, you know, stealing cars, hence the title of the movie, Gone in 60 Seconds. Directed by Michael Bay. That movie was an instant classic for a lot of us. And for him to call this new movie, Dream Scenarios, his best production ever, I just hope this production backs up those claims. Good luck, Nicolas Cage. In our next bit of news, was this year Hollywood's worst year ever? The Hollywood Reporter does a scathing report about the industry as a whole and what's been happening this entire year. At the very least, between a box office that hasn't yet recovered, the end of the peak TV, layoffs everywhere, the threat of AI to creative work and production halts, union strikes, 2003 wasn't good at all. A favorite parlor game for film buffs is to pick Hollywood's greatest year and then argue. The obvious answer, 1939, the certified golden year, always gets the most votes. Pretty much what this talks about is that this year has pretty much topped all of those previous years. It's pretty insane stuff because, you know, you and I were watching movies all year long, but really, you know, the entire business is down. For example, normally we put out 300 movies a year. This year we put about 219. So there's something as far as a downtrend that's happening in the Hollywood industry. And Hollywood Reporter pretty much wants to get to the bottom of it. The report also claims the question is prompted by end of the year mutterings that 2023 may be in the runnings. The double strike of screenwriters, the shutdowns, production, and left that kind of bitter aftertaste that makes it hard to kiss and make up. Gold chip stocks like MCU and Disney were left tarnished and dented after a string of would-be blockbusters were bust. In a year-end wrap-up of the industry blues, however, the bottom line for a bad year is always the bottom line. The profit margin is measured in weekly attendance figures and box office gross. No surprise that the early years of the Great Depression, any one of them, were ranked within the industry to be the next year that will be lower than the previous. It's been going on and on for quite some time. Now, if you got time, look into this report, read it, digest it, because they're on to something that's actually relevant in our time. We all enjoy movies. We all are a part of a movie, or we were once background in a movie, or we produced our own movies. We're all in this space, and we all need to be up to date on what's happening around this industry. In our next bit of news, Todd Phillips just released 2 new images from the upcoming Joker film, and they look exciting. Todd Phillips shares new images of Harley Quinn and Joker in the upcoming film Joker. In the upcoming Joker film, the first image reveals the Joker locked up in Arkham Asylum, raising questions about his fate after Joker. Cast includes Joaquin Phoenix, Lady Gaga, ZZ Beats, and Brandon Gleeson. For the last 2 years, Todd Phillips had been pretty excited about the sequel to his critically acclaimed Joaquin Phoenix led Joker, and his social media feeds back that up. Keeping up with his ways in his new holiday post, the writer-director has given fans a new look at Arthur Fleck in Arkham Asylum, which is likely where he'll fall in love with his psychiatric doctor Harley Quinzel, better known as Harley Quinn. played by Lady Gaga, setting the stage for Joker. While the first image in the post gives us a peek at Arthur Fleck locked behind bars, the second image sets a very different tone with Gaga's Harley Quinn looking adoringly at the Joker. Now, I think it's important to note that Joaquin Phoenix Joker is not connected to Robert Pattinson's Batman. So, just so we're clear. Or any of James Gunn's new slated DC films on the horizon. Phillips has been very straightforward about his film not being directly connected to the former DC Extended Universe as well. I'm excited for this movie. These images only put more excitement into my mind. I can't wait to see what Todd Phillips has to cook. I'm a huge Joaquin Phoenix fan. I'm on the fence about Lady Gaga, but by these images, they're going to give us a good show. Now, that's all the TV and movie news we have for today. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Let me know you love me. Let me know you care. Also, hit that like button. Let the algorithm know that we're here and we're here to stay. As always, have a great day, everyone.